I wanna know what love is. I need you to show me. Hi, it's Nick Schell, the Internet Receding Hairline Guy. Here's what I'm going to entitle this. I give you 5 years. That's the name of this video. I give you 5 years. I give it 5 years. Think of that as your diagnosis, your generic diagnosis. Keep in mind, I'm just pure entertainment. That's what I'm no expert. I really know nothing about hair loss other than what I've got going on here. That's all I know. And I've made hundreds of videos on this and people watch them, but I don't actually know any scientific stuff about this. I'm just telling you my experience on that. But still, with that being said, with me not being an expert and you continuing to watch these videos anyway, I give you 5 years. And here's why I generically say that. Because it's a daily, weekly thing that someone will reach out to me on Facebook or my email, send me pictures of their hairlines, and I don't mind, but they say, hey, how's my hairline look? Do you think I'm going to lose my hair or not? And most of the time, I'll say, you know what? I'll say, was that a gopher? Weird. Most of the time, I'll say, you know what? I can see where it's going up a little bit, but until you see that thinning, I wouldn't worry about it. That's usually what happens almost every time. But here's what I'm going to say. You know, am I going to be bald in 5 years? Am I going to be fundamentally bald to the point that I might as well shave it off? Maybe. I just assume I'm going to be. That way I'm prepared for it. I can still get away with having hair now. And if you really want to examine my hair, you can see my hairline and you can see thinness in spots, especially even right here sometimes you can see a spot. But I don't know. But it's all about being prepared mentally for that. So let's assume whether you're 35 like me or whether you're 15 or 20 or 25, just assume in your mind that you've got 5 years left before you lose so much hair that you do have to just shave it off because that's how much hair you've lost. Let's just go ahead and assume that, and no matter what age you are, okay? And keep that with you forever because let's assume you are 15 and then you make it to 20. You're like, okay, I don't have to shave my head. I still have most of my hairline went up a little bit, but I'm still good. Because keep in mind, that's my story. I started receding when I was 19, and I've still got this much hair left. So you never really can know for sure. There's a reality that you could be 15 and you really will lose most of your hair by 20. There's also a reality you'll be my age and have more hair than me. It's possible. We don't know for sure. But I think the best thing we can do is to tell ourselves 5 years remain. These are the last 5 good years of you having hair that you can still call hair without having to shave it off. Let's just go ahead and assume that. And that way, if you're wrong about this diagnosis about having 5 years left, then all right, I was wrong after all. Because keeping in mind that back when I was 19 and I went to the lady that cut my hair, what did she tell me? When I said, because I'm putting myself in your position, I was that guy in my teenage years asking that question. And she said, and she examined me very carefully. And see, she's the one, a lot of people say that I'm wrong about if you see the little baby hairs, that means you're receding. Of course, in the video, I was very clear to say in conjunction with the receding hairline. But it was her that originally told me, she said, well, you probably got to your 35. And I mean, she was pretty accurate. I still have hair. I'm 35. I'm not bald. But, you know, this is it. This is most likely the last couple of years of it. And even if I do slow down my hair loss, it's just a matter of I've got just enough hair to still do something with until it's going to have those thin spots in it. So what I want to remind you of, it's a matter of accepting it now, okay? Because I don't want you to freak out and worry about stuff you can't control on this as far as this goes. No matter what age you are, you're a male. What does that mean? It means it's in your genes to have male pattern baldness. Or at least receding. It's in your genes. You may luck out and never have to worry about it. Good for you. But if you're watching this video, that's probably not you. You're probably like me. So, accept it. 5 years. Do the best you can with it. And if I'm wrong and you still have hair, then good. I'm glad I'm wrong. I'm happy for you that you didn't have to go through that. But imagine this. If at whatever age you are right now, you accept this 5-year limitation. If you accept that it's all going to be over in 5 years for your hair, then how much prepared are you for it? You will be. You'll be quite prepared for it. And that's not to say you're to worry for 5 years. It just means you accept it for the next 5 years, what's probably going to happen. And there's no doom and gloom in that. As long as you accept that and realize that you're not being judged by the rest of the world as you judge yourself about this hairline thing. That's not how men are actually judged. Now, yes, maybe they judge each other. And maybe certain females are really into that and they wouldn't date a bald guy. But same could be said about guys who are only attracted to women with large breasts. I mean, that seems so superficial to me. Right? I mean, I've never cared about that. And therefore, and it's funny because, and then I ended up marrying someone who doesn't care about hair. She's like, if you go bald, just shave it off, whatever. It's normal, it's natural. So those are things to keep in mind. I give you 5 years, and I hope I'm wrong, but if I'm not, at least you'll be ready. My name is Nick Schell, and I am the internet receding hairline guy.